so delicious today, and I'm so excited. I'm Sherry with Backyard Bohemian, and I'm here at Everman, and we're going to be making a summer orzo Italian. Basically, everything that you want in an orzo dish is going to come together in like 10 minutes maximum. It's going to be so easy for you to just put together, put in your fridge, and come out and eat it later. Or you can eat it warm, whichever you like, but it's got a whole lot of good stuff. We're going to kind of start with a tabouli base, so we're going to be using parsley, green onions, I'm yelling now, and some mint, and this is all bought at Everman's today. We have some heirloom cherry tomatoes. We're going to use a little squeeze of lemon because that's just going to nicely enhance the olive oil. We're going to add some baby kale or arugula if you like a little bit more of a peppery flavor. And of course, we've got my beloved orzo, which you can never go wrong with. So we were actually just talking about this. Orzo is a pasta. It looks like rice, but it's a pasta. And if you want some more orzo ideas, which it boils in 10 minutes and comes together effortlessly, you can go onto my Backyard Bohemian blog and you can search orzo and it'll pull up fabulous recipes. So we just have a lot of some cherry tomatoes. We're gonna toss it in this bowl right here. And now we're going to go ahead with the cucumber, which you can cut your cucumber however you like, but I like to cut it into quarters because cucumber is a lot to put in your mouth at once. All right, nice. And you can do 1 cup, 2 cups, whatever your heart desires. I'm gonna stop right there because that seems like it's more than enough. Now we're gonna go ahead with the green onions, which you're gonna usually wanna top them because they get a little crunchy at the end. So discard the first half inch and then go ahead and do anywhere from a quarter cup to a half a cup, whatever you like. The beauty of this is that tabouli is supposed to be fresh and full of herbs. And so you can make this however you would like, but it is going to consist of green onions, parsley, and some mint. Next, we're gonna do 2 cups of parsley. And I know that sounds like a lot, and you're probably wondering, like, how am I going to eat this much in one dish? I know it's a lot, but trust me, trust the process, it's gonna come together beautifully. All right, rough chop it, and then you can go back and get it how you'd like. And try to take as many stems as you can out because it kind of ruins the aesthetic of it. All right, that's what 2 cups of parsley looks like. And now I'm going to drain the orzo real quick. Toss that right in the bowl. Minimum dishes. All right, next we're gonna go ahead and take some mint. And mint can overwhelm a dish pretty quickly, so we want to be vigilant about how much we put in it. If you are sensitive to the flavor, then I recommend doing just a couple of tablespoons, but you want it to be the bad flavor, not the whole taste of the dish. Start slow and work our way up. And since mint leaves can be a little bit small, you're gonna bunch them up in your fingers, bear claw it, and then you can rough chop it from there. Beautiful. Now we're gonna toss in a little bit of kale. Again, if you like a more peppery flavor, you can add arugula or even spinach. You can get creative, you can do whatever you like. And we're gonna do a nice cup because we want it to kind of blend in. All right, now here here comes the easiest dressing you'll ever make, but the most fresh and healthy one. So we're gonna have a lemon. I'm gonna do it right over my hand so there's no seeds in here. And we're gonna put about 3 tablespoons. And that will produce a mellow lemon flavor. It's not going to be too lemony. So if you do like more lemon, I would encourage to maybe add some lemon wedges to your personal plate. And a little splash of olive oil. Again, about maybe 3 tablespoons or more. We're gonna do a little more because I really love olive oil. Beautiful. And we're gonna finish it with a little bit of Mediterranean sea salt. Always, always, always pour it over your hands first because you never wanna just dump salt into your dish. It could be a disaster that you cannot fix. We're gonna finish that off right there. Toss it together. There you go. That's a 10-minute vegan, easy to make lunch, dinner, whatever you like. I actually bought some vegan cheese to top it with. I'm really excited to try that. It's a little bit softer than your normal feta, so I think it was probably made with like a cashew base. It looks really delicious. I'm really excited for that. But here you go. Super easy. If you like the link with the precise measurements, it's on www.backyard-bohemian.com. Stay safe.